We are going to play a game. It is called Nim game. There are several variations in this game and we are going to see a simple version. For this game, we need two players, player 1 and player 2. In front of them, we have 43 coins. The game starts with player 1 and the players play alternatively. At each of their turn, each player can take any number of coins that is less than 5. That is, each player can take 1 coin or 2 coins or 3 coins or 4 coins. But they have to take at least 1 coin during their turn. So each player takes some number of coins alternatively. For instance, player 1 can take 1 coin at the start, followed by player 2 taking 2 coins. Again, the player 1 in his turn can take 4 coins, and so on. The game ends when there is no more coin to take. The winner is the last person who has taken the last of the coins. To understand the game better, let us try a sample run. Here we have 43 coins initially. For our convenience, let us consider the case when there are 10 coins. Let us see the sample run. The game starts with player 1 and player 1 takes 2 coins. So 8 coins will remain. Again, player 2 takes 3 coins. So 5 coins will remain. Now it is player 1's turn. He takes 1 coin. So 4 coins will remain. Now the player 2 can take all the remaining 4 coins and hence he wins the game. So this is how the game works. Let us come back to our original problem with 43 coins. Now the question is, does any of the player have a winning strategy? Winning strategy is a strategy that ensures that the player who follows it will always win no matter what the opponent does. In this case, one of the players has a winning strategy and that player is player 1. Let us see what the winning strategy is. The initial number of coins is 43. Remember, each player can take any number of coins less than 5 and each player has to take at least 1 coin during their turn. The winning strategy is as follows. Player 1 has to take 3 coins in his first move. So 40 coins will remain. Note that 40 is the multiple of 5. Now the next turn is for player 2. He may take any number of coins less than 5. So as 40 is the multiple of 5, if he takes any number of coins less than 5, then the remaining number of coins will not be the multiple of 5. For example, suppose P2 takes 2 coins, then the remaining number of coins is 40 minus 2, which is 38. And that is not the multiple of 5. So player 2 will always leave the number of coins, which is not the multiple of 5. In the next turn, now player 1 has to take appropriate number of coins so as to leave the number of coins that is the multiple of 5. This can be easily done by dividing the remaining number of coins, in this case 38, by 5 and taking out the remaining number of coins. So he has to do it by dividing the remaining number of coins by 5 and taking out the remainder number of coins. Since the remainder is always less than 5, as we divide it by 5, this is possible. When we divide 38 by 5, the remainder is 3. So player 1 has to take 3 coins. So 35 coins will remain, which is again the multiple of 5. So this goes on and on. In the next move, as the remaining number of coins is the multiple of 5, that is 35, no matter what player 2 takes, he will always leave the number of coins that is not the multiple of 5. And that can be again made the multiple of 5 by player 1 by taking appropriate number of coins, which is the remainder when the number of coins is divided by 5. So throughout the game, by following this strategy, the player 1 always leaves the number of coins that is the multiple of 5 and player 2 will always leave the number of coins that is not the multiple of 5. The final player who takes the last of the coins is the winner. That is, the final player who leaves zero number of coins is the winner. Zero is the multiple of 5, and player 1 alone can leave the number of coins that is the multiple of 5. Hence, player 1 at some point will leave zero number of coins, and hence he will be the winner. So that is it. No matter what player 2 does, player 1 will always win if he follows this strategy. So the winning strategy for the player 1 is: take 3 coins in the first move, making the remaining coins to be the multiple of 5, that is 40, 3 taken from 43. Now in the subsequent moves, player 1 has to take the remainder number of coins when the number of coins is divided by 5. That is this: take number of coins mod 5. So that is it, a very simple winning strategy. The crucial idea here is to find some property that can only be achieved by one player. And if the final winning state also shares that property, then that player can ensure his winning. Here in this game, that property is the remaining number of coins being the multiple of 5, which can only be achieved by player 1. In most of the games like this, we will be hunting for such property. We will soon discuss more games like this. Thanks for watching and have a great day.